Hello guys, welcome back to a brand new video, and today I will be talking about all the features in the environment library from Synapse's documentation. Although most experts have this, just not the shit ones. But yeah, I will basically be making this into a series who explain different exploit functions and stuff like that. I'll probably have something wrong in this video, so if you want to tell me about what I messed up, then please do it in the comments. I will release another video for this series if we reach 25 likes, so make sure to like if you like the video. But yeah, with all of that said, let's start the video. Most people know that you can use GetGen to make a global value, but they also don't know how or why it works. GetGen basically creates or gets a value from the exploit environment, which makes it non-detectable and a lot better than underscore g dot or g dot, whatever you want to call it, since that's on the Roblox's environment and can be detected. The script that you see right now is an example on how to make a global value of GetGen. The test is the name of the variable and yes is the value of the variable. Then to access it, just do GetGen.test. You probably heard of GetGen, but have you heard of GetRen? GetRen will return all the values of something from the Roblox environment. For example, returning all of the g dot values from the Roblox environment. Script shown right now will print all the g dot values from the Roblox scripts. You have probably already heard of GetEasy, but here is a really simple script which prints all of the garbage collected values, often called up values. This can be used for making gun mods like in my previous videos, so if you want to know more about it, then watch some of my previous gun mod videos, not the one from Prison Life though. Get instances is a function for returning all the instances, basically all the items etc. inside of the game which has a parent. The script you see right now will print all the current instances slash items etc. in the game. This is exactly like get instances, just that it returns all the instances without the parent, basically where the parent is nil. As the last script, the script you see right now will print all the instances without the parent slash with a nil parent. Get scripts will return all the module scripts and local scripts, although not server-side script slash normal script. This is quite straightforward. Script to see right now will be printing all the local scripts and model scripts inside of the game. Get loaded modules is basically like the get scripts, just that it only gets the module scripts. Quite nice when you want to dump the module scripts, etc. Script to see right now will print all of the module scripts inside of the game. Get connections will return all the connections. So basically connections are groups of signals slash, for example, a mouse button, one click of the button. Here's a script which disables all the connections for a button, basically makes it unusable for you. Fire signal is used to fire signals. For example, the script you see right now basically simulates a button click. Fire click detector is used to fire and click detector, exactly as the name says. Can be used, for example, simulating picking up items, etc., depending on how the game's scripted it. Script you see right now fires and click detector. Fire proximity prompt, as the name says, will fire proximity prompt. I don't think I have to explain that much. The script you see right now is an example on how to use it. Same thing here, this fires and touch interest, basically simulates touching a part. Here's an example on how to use it. This network owner returns if the part is so-called owned by the player. This function and the last function is mostly used in making FE script. Here is how you can use it. Get hidden property checks if a so-called hidden property with the input and name exists. Either it errors if it doesn't exist or it returns the value of the hidden property. Here's an example on how to use it. This sets a hidden property. Quite straightforward, the script you see right now is how to use it. This is mostly used for making FE scripts, etc. I haven't really used it and I don't exactly know how to use it. But here's an example on how to use it, at least from what I found. Thank you for watching the video. If you liked it, then please like. And if you want to see more videos, then please comment what you want me to explain, etc. Otherwise, I will just explain something random inside of the synapse documentation. But yeah, this was quite fun to make, but it was quite hard. But yeah, let's just end the video right here. Bye bye.